Hey there, everybody. We're gonna play Beyond Awesome in a rebuild cage match. So here we go. I don't know what that noise was. Anyway. Let me look at this board. Oh great, I'm already having connection problems. Well, you can do big engine. Yeah, I mean, that's got to be better than rebuild here. That doesn't seem even particularly close. Well, all right, I'm gonna anyway, about the board, I think, I mean, I think you could make a claim to playing with the silver. Are we just gonna keep hitting these? I guess so. This will be a wharf. Oh good, he had a some kind of dud. I expect to add treasure maps at some point in the game. Here my draws have been better than his. I should have left that on top. All right, well, I stopped the stream because basically because it wasn't working. And anyway, the recording should still be fine. This game should be about wrapped up for me. I'm just way ahead of him. So, I need to get some more wharves, and probably some more ports, or probably some ports. This game looks like it's over. I don't know why he played both of his wharves last time, but I can start provincing. I think I'll save one of the wars for okay, so that's game one. I want to check first player. First player was him. Okay. So one start for him, one win for me. So, anyway, this board maybe you could play with rebuild. There's not actually a really clear engine. So maybe you can do like a. I wonder how gear does against rebuild. Triple gear. I guess I could find out. I don't know how gear and jack interact. I guess I could find that out too. We'll try that. We'll try something that's money, but not. We'll try something that's not rebuild. We'll just see how it goes. I don't really have any idea how this will go, but yeah, I want to set aside an estate or a copper, maybe. What am I going to have in hand? Three copper, so another one doesn't really help. This is nice. I get to trigger the shuffle with gear and four copper in it. Well, we'll discard that. We don't need it. This should be a gold for me. Yeah, that was a nice flip for him. I don't know that it is actually all that useful to put in a estate there, so we won't. This here I will buy third gear. think. I'm not sure this jack's ever really gonna do much for me, but. There, I'm just gonna province. I think I should be able to province. Well, you know, not every time, but a little, somewhat consistently. With between the silvers and the gears. At least I hope so. So here I will do gear silver. And buy another silver. Okay, so I have nine here, so I can do silver in a state, or copper in a state, I should say. Yeah, we'll leave that. Trash this guy. And I think I'm gonna start on duchies. I feel okay about this turn. It'll depend, of course, on how his rebuild draws go. But it seems to be going okay for me. I don't like his rebuild there particularly. Okay, I have nine again. So, get to set aside a copper. This is province again. Yeah, now he's rebuilding for nothing. He could have bought a duchy, but now he's just milling provinces, and that doesn't even help him, I don't think. Maybe. I don't really see how. Okay, so I have a lot of money here. 11. I think I can take a province safely. I will leave that. Done trashing. Taking a state. Well, if I don't province here, I'll definitely be in a position to well, you hit a lot of duchies there. Right. I don't remember who started that one. He did again. So that's two for me. All right, that's all his starts. Okay, so this board, there's an engine. It's not the greatest of engines. It's not the worst. so I don't know though. The trashing's pretty weak. That's the issue, I'd say. That's the big issue. So I think I will take a silver opening and try for a rebuild here. I can see going for transmogrify as well. I don't think ghost ship is. I don't think ghost ship is very good. So I guess we'll find out what he does this time. He is not going for the rebuilds, or at least not right away. So I'm mostly fine with that. Though the Haggler, of course, is nice. Yeah, I just don't think Ghost Ship really slows rebuild down very much. I could take a pawn, sure. Maybe it does, but I mean, now I can just toss these He hasn't even played it yet. Okay. I can always put green cards on top of the deck. Here I'm going to put a Border Village and a Copper back, and then that'll give me a good transmogrify target next time. There's a really nice engine here, but I guess I'm just hoping that he doesn't fire off every turn because there's no trashing. Alright, I'm going to transmogrify this into a rebuild, which I will then play. And then, so, yeah, I really should take a coin. I don't necessarily want to cycle either. I mean, it probably doesn't hurt me to cycle, but it will ease my mind at least if I don't cycle, because I won't draw a rebuild dead accidentally. So oof, this ain't good. He's just No, he's not there. I could take another transmogrify. They're pretty nice. So far no rebuild mirrors. Well, I guess I want to save this stuff, so I'll rebuild and then. Yeah, that's nice, this border village grave robber stuff. I just need him to have some turns where he doesn't kick off his draw, which he doesn't have that much draw, so it's not really that much of a stretch for it not to happen, but who knows? He did get a province, okay. So that's sad. Wow, that's really sad. That's one of the worst rebuild reveals I've ever seen in my life. That's incredible. Wow, that's killer. I don't know that I had a great chance of winning, but that's gonna definitely shut it down completely. Since that's all the. Well, I have one more rebuild. Okay, so never mind. It didn't totally shut. Excuse me. It doesn't totally shut it down, but. Doesn't make it a really great odds. I don't know if I keep taking these pawns. They don't do much, but they probably don't hurt either, so. He, of course, has lots of border villages, so he doesn't dud often. I'm just a little surprised at how often he's drawn the nobles at the start. Should have been a copper, obviously, but. That I top deck there, but so he should have this win pretty s easily. I think. I don't think there'll be any question. He'll get it here. I'm not sure why he's taking duchies. Guess he's gonna rebuild them. He just got such a big point lead now. I mean, it's huge. It's absolutely huge. So. I can't catch him. Yeah, I can resign because I can't catch him. There's no. He's too far ahead in points. Okay, so. Now I'm starting the rest. Should have played the engine there. It seems like his draws were a little above average, but. Still pretty good engine. I'm not gonna make that same mistake again. So I'm gonna open silver here, get torturers, put lost arts on them, and get an expand and expand stuff. You could open squire, but I mean, you don't actually care about the actions, so at least not at this point. So I don't see why you'd take one at the start. It'll, with the hit it would take to your odds of hitting five. Yeah, I don't see anything but just trying to pile on tortures with lost arts. I guess, yeah, I can see thinking about getting a squire. So, that's not crazy, but. Expand should be really, really nice. There are fives and sixes to hit with your estates and silvers, so. Pilgrimage probably will be good, I think. At least maybe once or twice. It's a way you can put your coppers towards getting grand markets. I don't know who. If it's a connection thing again? Or. What's going on here? I'll wait another minute before I prompt him. Now beyond. Right, so we're not playing this torture thing. So this board is probably only either rebuild or embassy money. I don't really know how those two compare. They're probably. Well, I guess it's a definite silver opening. So, okay. Little chat. So I'll take silver, silver. I don't actually know. I mean, maybe Embassy Big Money beats Rebuild. Probably on good draws it does. I mean, I don't see. Of course it could on good draws. But I don't know kind of what the split is on average. I have no idea. So I'll try the rebuild. I had obviously really nice draws here, so here we got a rebuild mirror. Wow, this is pretty crazy. I think now you go to Dutchies already, right? Since I have two rebuilds. Since I just had super perfect draws. And I continue to have super perfect draws. So. Okay, here I can hit the two estates and I'll be way, way, way ahead. Which is pretty crazy. This is like complete dream hits there. So I have five duchies to his three. I don't know if I even won anything. Mean, I guess I can take a caravan guard, it doesn't get in the way of playing rebuilds. I should win unless the suddenly no I never draw a rebuild and he always does. But other than that I should have a big lead here. I'll get another rebuild. He's gonna really have to get a province, like buying a province to catch me. So I think for him, I would have taken something else there. But like maybe an embassy. Okay, I still have three duchies. Or two duchies. Wow, and I even buy a province. Yeah, this has just been incredibly lopsided draws this game. Like crazy bad as far as how much better mine were than his. All right, so that's game four. Two more. I guess the question is, can you make a horn engine work here with just the universities as your villages? Probably. You don't have to get that many provinces in your megaturn. It's kind of a weird one, though. A little bit of a weird one, I should say. I think I will like a caravan guard and a potion on the opening. I mean, the idea here would just be to get the upgrades fast. That would be the goal, at least, which should be doable. I could see opening a vagrant. I'm not sure that the, I mean, you could also just take. You could play with rebuilds in your university deck, I guess. It might be a little odd, but you could do it. If I hit four here, I will take a salvager. He's getting a young witch, which is just fine with me. This will be a salvager. Play that guy. That gets me to an upgrade, which is nice. I'll gain another upgrade, trash a copper and buy a vagrant. Hopefully blocking every once in a while. I'm gonna have to block a lot, but just, you know, a block or two would be nice. I'll probably take a haggler. Ooh, he's moving on this young witch. That's not great. Okay, since that's there. I will take a rabble at this stage. Though, I don't like the horn. I don't care for the horn. That's a really bad draw. I'm gonna take another curse here. Probably. Nope. Okay. We may get out of this unscathed. This shuffle. I don't care for the horn yet, but that's okay. Don't care for the second horn either. His draw's not that great yet. Well, I don't know what I have left in this deck, yes, excellent. That's really good. Maybe a little bit lucky. So the piles are kind of low, but that's all right. Think I have a vagrant down here in the bottom. I don't know how this is gonna pan out. Well, it's gonna be a pile out, that's for sure. Look at that. It's quite the toss. He probably has a horn. No, no horns. Okay. Come on, Vagrant. There you go. Ooh, I need a rabble. Thank you. Thank you. I could get a rogue. That's whatever. I could get a young witch now, actually. He doesn't have the vagrants. I'm not sure if he's... I mean, if he has the deck under control, then... the young witch doesn't do a whole lot, but... I could... I guess it should have been another rabble. That's very sad. Very close to a three pile. Just because we have so many universities. It's a nice term for him. Curses. I don't know if on my turn if I could end it. I don't know if I have quite that many. He's gotten thin here. I'll need him to have a bit of a dud hand, I think. But he could cash his horns in now for provinces if he wants, I suppose. That's a little weird to me. I can't imagine he didn't have eight. Right, universe, he didn't have it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He had eight. Let's see what we get here. This could be total dud hand. Yep. So the question is, should I toss away my ability to threaten a three pile on universities? That probably doesn't matter now, so we'll do this. It's a really bad turn for me. His rabbles hit me very hard there. All I can do is hope that he dud somewhat, but I'm guessing that's not the case given that he's choosing to take horns of plenty there. I'm gonna assume he has some universities and rabbles in hand. He gains a young witch, huh? That's a little weird to me, but he seems to be focused on this, he seems to be focusing on this Horn of Plenty mega turn when you'd just be glad to empty the piles and get out of here, you know? Like, here he is, he's just running down these Horns of Plenty. But I don't know if the game lasts that long. I mean, it's pretty weird to me. Hopefully I don't draw dead here. But who knows? Alright, well, the dream is alive. I don't know how many universities I have. Doesn't really matter. I can empty the piles, I'm sure. I can't believe he didn't get any points there. That's so strange to me. Well, anyway, that's the game, so. He was just lasered in on doing the horns. But, oh, this has got to be me starting. Well, so here you can, oh, he's having connection troubles again. I guess we'll see if he's got his shuffle or his thing. I don't know what's good here. It's good to, oh. He must have had some connection problem. It's a great system, let me tell you. Well, okay, I'll take 5-2 here as well. That's fine. Wow. Yeah, I'll take 5-2 here. So I think you can probably build an engine with the storytellers. I don't see any reason why you couldn't, so we're going to do that. We'll open with the mountebank, obviously, and then probably take a spice merchant if we hit 4, and then otherwise take a forager if we hit 3, and then probably this could be a few different things. So this could be a sage or a forager or even a rat catcher really, or it could be a silver. Could be a silver. So, we don't have one of those in there yet. Forge, I mean, trashing is good. Turns out. With the mountebank already, I think I'll take the forger. 5 is fine to hit, really. It's not a big deal. I will take 8 coin. Just because we'll probably have a second mountebank in here now. And we'd like to use it. This is going to be for me a storyteller. And this is going to be for me a haggler. So I guess we'll play all of these because we could trash curse. That's nice. I want to hit 6 sometime, but that can come later. I've had really, really great draws. clearly. Or at least so far. He buys a couple of rat catchers, okay. I don't need to call the rat catcher just this second. Story or the coin is really nice here. I guess I've got co- well, I well, what would I rather have, the copper or the curse? This is nice gold, and then oh, he has a third mountain bank. It's interesting. I think another storyteller. I really like the storytellers here. One, two, three, four, five, six. So I have seven, so I can call the rat catcher now. The swamp hags are kind of cute too. I can get another haggler. I don't actually have the coins to support that just at this moment. All right, this is really nice for me. It would be just super hard for me to lose at this point. I can tr as well. Anyway, it would be pretty difficult. Okay, so play these guys. We could play the platinum and just draw everything really quickly. Anyway, I didn't do that perfectly by any stretch, and by that I mean I screwed it up, but that's okay. It doesn't matter. So, I don't see a pile out really, so. Alright, C's resigning. So that went 5-1 for me. I had really good luck in at least two of them. Like, really, really good. So, not too much rebuild in the rebuild cage match, which is, we had one mirror, and then we had a couple where one person went for it and the other person did not, and the person who didn't go for rebuild won. And then we had two where we just ignored it, I guess. Two or three where we ignored it. So, anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see ya next time.